Welcome to the Path Monk Presents podcast. My name is Sean Donnelly Lewis, and in today's episode, we're speaking with founder and CCO at Nexta.io, Martin Jensen. Martin, how's it going?
Good. Thanks for having me. Thanks for having me.
Sweet background you got going on, by the way.
Yeah, it's actually not me doing that painting. That's actually something that we are borrowing towards your creation. So nice.
Very good
nice. Painting. Yeah.
Something else that's really nice is Nexta.io. Tell us all about it.
Yeah, and thanks for listening into the story here. So as you mentioned, my name is Martin. I'm co-founder, CCO of Nexta.io, founded the company 4 years ago, headquartered based out of the sunny and lovely Copenhagen today, at least. So I think the question why did we find Nexta.io was actually because we saw a need in the market to help small, medium-sized business to grow their digital marketing presence. I think as we all are aware, when you look at a digital marketing today, it's getting more and more complex, more and more channels are popping up, Snapchat, TikTok, Facebook, Instagram, Google search, you know, if you're a small, medium-sized business, where to start and where to end. So based on that problem, we decided to build a software as a service platform towards SMEs, where they essentially can log in and do advertising across channels. So our go-to-market from the beginning have been driven primarily by a partner strategy, meaning that we are actually not serving SMEs directly through our platform. We are serving them through partners such as classifieds and publisher who have, you know, access to many of these SMEs globally and within the European space. So today speaking, 40 people in the company, primarily engineering of background. I think 80% of our total staff now is still based on engineering and product. So headquartered in Copenhagen, have offices in Berlin, recently just got a small office in US with one guy there. And then all our development people is based in Budapest and Poland, so to speak.
And so have you guys been able to grow the company? Has it been a lot of inbound or outbound? And which avenues do you use?
Yeah, so in that question, we do both. As mentioned in the beginning, our go-to-market is quite simple, must say. You know, we have a partner strategy where we identified publishers and classifieds. When we started the company, we were, you know, founded here in the Nordics. We decided to cover the, so to speak, backyard before going globally. So, you know, for us, it was a bit of outreach through LinkedIn, getting, you know, attention through LinkedIn, social media, getting demo requests to the websites, that, you know, the bit of more classic social media approach, and then also leveraging some of the network we had in the past, as I've been working with a lot of publishers and classifieds in my previous job. So it's a combination on building awareness, driving leads, and then also utilizing your network, so to speak.
And what role does the website play in acquiring new clients for you guys?
So in the beginning, the role the website was playing wasn't that big, because I think in the beginning we were, you know, leveraging the network we had, sold so we are a license-based company selling license on a monthly basis. We were, and it's a partner strategy, so it's not around, you know, tons of clients. It's more, you know, the right clients and the right partner. So in that case, not that much. But as our outreach is now going towards Europe, US, and a bit more global footprint, the outbound marketing is been much more aggressive, where we're actually leading all the leads to our marketing, to our website, and based on the website, we are, so to speak, converting leads into demo calls, converting demo calls into meetings, and hopefully in the end convert a demo call into a client.
And usually when I have marketeers or founders on the show, they talk about their website, and there's a lot that they love and there's a lot that they would like to improve. Yeah. If you were to improve something about the website, what would it be? Would it be the ability to convert, the quality of leads, or the user experience?
Yeah, so I actually think we nailed the user experience, so to speak. But again, for us, how do you, as we as a software company, we are actually, some of the stuff that we have communicated is a bit complex. So how do you find the balance between actually communicating to the users what is the value of Nexta, and how do we actually get those guys to understand the value proposition and then convert to a demo? So what's the, you know, I think figuring out still is a bit ongoing task, and I think that will be an ongoing task forever. How do you balance actually to give the users the right information and then actually also ensure that these guys will convert? And they actually might want to convert in the first time they visit Nexta.io, but they might convert later on in the buying journey as we as a software service company, right?
And coming back to your SaaS platform for everyone listening in, what would you say you guys do different than other people that occupy the same space? What separates what you guys do a little bit?
Yeah, so on the equation here, I actually think the go-to-market is that we are addressing a partner strategy, which is publishers and classified. So our go-to-market compared to our competitors is really different. So we're not going directly to small, medium-sized enterprise to have them to log in to our platform. That's the go-to-market bit. And on the commercial part and the value proposition that we are providing to SMEs through our partners is our ability to actually optimize towards performance marketing across channels. Meaning, if I'm an SME, want to use $10,000 in advertising, we will actually be the one, based on our optimization ending, looking for the lowest cost per click for the best price, so to speak. So it's a performance marketing engine who actually is agnostic. It actually don't favors Google toward Facebook. It will favor the performance.
Very cool. And so this is part of the show where I get to pick marketeers' brains a little bit about the way that they see the world. And obviously, marketeers are always a good conversation when it comes to marketing. So when you think about a certain word like innovation, what would you say is the biggest challenge as a marketeer when you try and integrate innovation, when you try and innovation in a company?
Yeah, so I think getting back to your questioning around the website and the outreach and how we are, you know, seeing the future going ahead, I still think we are still searching for what to say the magic in what we call, you know, predictable revenue. So whenever, you know, we are using LinkedIn and paid media channels, how do we actually ensure that we are converting our marketing spend to return of investment? And as you are is aware, we are B2B SaaS company. We actually have a quite high willingness to pay X amount of dollars for a lead, but how do we actually ensure whatever we are spending on the social channel that we do the, so to speak, the follow-ups correctly, and we actually take the potential client through the funnel? So that's, I think, what we call predictable revenue, where you see companies like Salesforce and others have been tremendously good at building that predictable revenue based on marketing spend and outreach through salespeople.
And as a marketeer, just again, thinking your personal opinion, what would you say is the biggest challenge when it comes to conversion optimization?
Yeah, so the conversion optimization, I think I would, for me, this is also related in our industry to the content, right? You need to tweak a lot of your content to actually figure out which content will convert best. And I think going a bit back, if you don't have the content to show the user, then you will have a hard time actually converting those. So I think for us in general, as we speak, we are tweaking and testing a lot of, you know, content, testing headlines, changing images. And based on all of this, actually having the time being to tweak and test, because I think building a big marketing strategy in those days, I fundamentally believe in testing a lot and actually doing that a bit in real time, because you see the the infrastructure behind all the digital marketing now is that you can do a lot of stuff in real time, which is amazing. There's all the infrastructure behind bidding and buying, advertising, targeting audience, vice versa. But we tend to forget about the content and the creative. So I think in that manner, we are, that's the holy grail going forward is content and creative.
Very cool. And I just want to switch gears here for a second and talk about you as a leader. Martin, yeah. What kind of content do you consume to educate yourself and grow as a person and as a professional?
Yeah, so so I think, you know, LinkedIn is still, you know, a primarily channel for me to use in terms of, you know, following the right, you know, business leaders, having, you know, a lot of, you know, good information there. Then also, you know, specific title as Ad Exchange, Exchange Wire, because that's a part of our industry as well. And then, you know, companies and you know, role models in the software as a service company, following the founder of Sastra and these kind of types who have been, you know, really, really good at, you know, building software as a services companies, so to speak.
Have you tried Clubhouse? This is not a plug for Clubhouse.
Yeah, I tried Clubhouse. I was about to mention it. The reason why I didn't mention it is because I'm out again. I tried it a few weeks and it didn't caught my attention. So yeah. And I can't point out why. I don't know if it was about the format or the content, but I might need to revisit it again. We tried it. There was a lot of hype on it, but been there for a few weeks and haven't been there for a month now. So I don't know. I dropped out a bit.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, we are slowly coming to the end of the interview. But before we do, we just have some rapid fire questions. So they're just short and sweet, but answer as honestly as possible. You ready?
Yes.
All right, Martin, what was the last book that you read?
Reed Hastings, Netflix, and I can't remember the title. That tells a lot. It's been a while since I had it, but it was.
It's a book about Netflix.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I can't
interesting.
Remember the title actually.
All right.
Reed,
what is this?
Yeah, it was the founder. It's the founder of Netflix, Reed Hastings. Can't
okay.
remember the title, but it's been
okay,
a while.
Okay, that's his name. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Didn't learn something new every day here, Martin.
Okay.
What's the single thing that your company is focused on at the moment the most?
So as we are growing our organization rapidly, hiring in more people, culture within our company, how do we sustain a startup and a growth culture, even though that we are growing from, you know, 30 people to 40 plus, how do we continue to have the culture and the DNA of being agile?
If there were no boundaries in technology, what would be the one thing you want to have fixed for your company today?
Whoa, that was a hard one. So I think the layer of automation, you know, marketing automation, if we all talk about marketing automation, but in the end, not all is automated. So having, you know, seamless system to actually, you know, integrate and talk together, right, you know, doing a lot of conversation on LinkedIn and meetings, and then you need to connect to your CRM and your Outlook. So seamless connection between the walled gardens will be a big help for all, I guess.
Very cool. What's the last thing that kept you awake at night about your company?
Again, how do we stay, you know, actually, I must put the word, how do we, as we have been here for 4 years now and we are working with, you know, big clients, how do we actually still innovate and disrupt ourselves so we are not becoming, you know, too, so to speak, not the word lazy, but how do we keep our company becoming agile and keep, you know, challenge the decision and the product we are building on a daily basis?
If you were to start your company over again, what would be the one piece of advice you give yourself?
Have a good co-founder, which I had.
Good. It'd be kind of strange if he heard this and it wasn't. All right.
Yes.
Great. Everyone, that was Martin Jensen. You can check out all the great work that they're doing at nexta.io. Martin, thank you so much for being on the show today. The last thing about the last order of business we have is the last word. So if you want to sum up everything that we talked about, or if you feel like there's something that we forgot, I just want to give you the last word today. The floor is yours.
I think we all good here, covered fine.
Sounds good. Martin, thanks for your time.
You too.